Hey, welcome back everyone. Today, actually, I'm talking about fears. How to manage your fears and why mindset is very important. To talk about that, I'm having my friend, Ritu Sharma from UK. She's entrepreneur, speaker, and coach. She talks a lot about women empowerment. She has written a book, Rich Dad's Poor Daughter. And she has a lot of fascination towards the empowerment of people and generating their mindset. So let us have some golden nuggets from her today. Just Ritu, just tell people, what is the mindset to come out of the fear?
Hello, everybody. First of all, thank you, Ashish, for having me on your platform. Great to be here. Loving this energy and hoping to connect with some like-minded, lovely people looking forward to convert their mindsets onto the next level. Mindset, Ashish, in my understanding, is the key to anything you want to do, anything you want to achieve in your life. Because once you've got your mindset correct, correctly attuned, shall I say, then it becomes possible for you to not just position yourself in terms of authority and position yourself in a way where you know exactly what you want. You also know how you can achieve that. And I'm not saying it becomes easier, but once the path is clear, the destination is achievable. And that's what the mindset does for you.
Yes. Okay. So what could be the right mindset? Like, if you could see these days, what is happening is here in India, there is a latest development about JET employees losing their around. These people are losing 20,000 jobs. People are losing jobs everywhere. I'm an entrepreneur myself. So even most of the times, even we do face fear of losing clients. Even we do face fear of losing the business. And a lot of people find it difficult. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, with fear, it's a human emotion. And like any other emotion of negativity, love, you know, jealousy, of hatred, anything, it's just an emotion. And I think it's overrated quite a lot because we as human beings, whenever there's a need or an opportunity for change, we kind of evaluate ourselves and the situation quite a lot. And sometimes we overthink, and that does not go in our favor either, right? So fear is, what is fear basically? It's a natural instinct that is placed within us to protect us, right? So we need to know whether we should fight a situation or whether we should leave the situation, run, fight or flight mode. And that is why fear is within us. It's there to protect us really. And that's fine. It's a needed emotion because otherwise we'll carry on making the same mistakes over and over again and not learn from them. But once we hurt, then the next time we are positioning ourselves in a similar situation, we are fearful that this might hurt us again. So we make a better evaluated decision then whether to pursue, whether to withdraw. However, fear is not something you can live by. It is important in a way, it's good in a way, it keeps you safe in a way, it protects you. However, living in fear is the worst someone can do for themselves. Right?
Yes.
So we need to learn the lessons that have been taught, that were needed to be taught to us from, you know, the previous experiences. But we can't just sit there and not expect or not look forward or make our way forward to change the next time we're trying to move forward. We can acknowledge the fear. We can accept it like we would accept any difficult situation in our life and say, okay, it's here. Thank you very much for this. I've got the message. But thank you. No, thank you. And then, you know, do what needs doing anyway. Because if we sit in fear, as we always hear, nothing changes unless you change something.
Yes.
And I'm a personal believer of a constant change. When you're changing, you're actually growing. And
what do you okay, sorry to interrupt.
No, it's okay, carry on.
So what to say to your little voice? What do you normally say to your little voice? Like most of the time, people who are performing on the jobs, they are under constant fear. And there is a situation of flux. if I lose my this current boss, I'll be out of this company. They are attached to the boss. They are attached to the company. They are attached to so many things. So as a person who is expert into this domain, what would you suggest again?
Right. Okay. Let me tell you about being connected and being attached to the company or the boss. I know personally people, Ashish, who worked in one particular company for 22 odd years of their life, right?
And then
the circumstances changed and they needed to get rid of people. The company got rid of them like that, without a second thought. And okay, they were made redundant. They were let go. But then the company or the employer or the boss or the manager, they did not think about the employee themselves. They were thinking of the company itself. What was in the interest of the company? And that's how things work, isn't it?
Yeah.
Now, can you say what's going to happen tomorrow? Okay, can you tell me what's going to happen in 5 years' time? Or whether the work you're doing now, Ashish, would you be doing that in 10 years' time? Probably you would be, and you would have excelled and, you know, gone further up. But we don't know. What do we know? What do we have in our hands? Is the moment now, right? Correct. So my advice to anybody, a student who's fearing examinations, an employee who's worried about their job, an entrepreneur, a business person who's trying to build a business and is not sure whether it's a great idea, whether they'll explore, whether they'll be successful, whether they'll achieve what they want to achieve. My advice is very basic and very straightforward. Believe in the process. You can only see so much further, right? Base your decision of going further on the experiences and the lessons you've had so far. And you can only decide for now. You can't decide for 10 years after or 5 years after. And maybe that's a good thing. We don't know. And you would agree with me that the failures we experience are the greatest lessons we ever learn. Correct. And that's how it is. So I totally believe in just carrying on. Do your best of your ability. Do the best to your ability. Try and hit your potential to the best. Try not to get attached to the boss or the company. Just do your job. Your job, honestly, with all your your personal might, and leave everything else to God or the supernatural power, whatever you call it, whatever you believe in, and believe that everything happens for a reason.
Yes.
And I think that's the only thing that can bring peace of mind in any situation, given situation, to a human being, Ashish.
So you were talking about the mindset. So what should be the right mindset as such?
The right mindset, according to me, is knowing that things change.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Everything's going to change. What you have now is not going to be there. Maybe it will be, maybe it won't be. We don't know. There's no guarantee to that. It's not been promised. Things are changing all the times. So be ready for change. It might upset you sometimes, but then unless things change, we don't grow. And there's a really beautiful quote that I normally say that, you know, instead of letting life live through you, let your life turn upside down. You don't know that the side you know now is better than the one that you'll get after. It's all topsy-turvy. We don't know. So be ready for change. And yes, it's not possible to be happy all the times. It's a myth. All the coaches, all the consultants, all the counselors who ever tell you to be positive all the times, unfortunately, they're not embracing the truth. We are human beings and we are ought to be upset at times. We ought to be emotional. We ought to be angry. And sometimes we have a liking or dislike, this feeling of disliking for others as well, which is okay. And we should accept it as okay. It's all right. We're human beings and we feel all these emotions for a reason. As long as we're accepting them, acknowledging them and saying, okay, so if you don't like anybody, you don't have to go and hurt them. It's okay to not like someone if you don't like them. There might be a reason, there might not be a reason. Just acknowledge that and say, okay, that person can go on to their own journey and I can go on to my own journey. I don't have to get in the way or they don't have to get in my way. It's multi-layered, you see. Just accepting what is, it's multi-layered, then it becomes It's quite simple though, but it's multi-layered.
Okay. Anything more you would like to share, Ritu? Because as I understand, you have a lot to share.
We have a lot to share, definitely. Well, I would also like to say, and one thing I always talk about is love. And what we
You talk a lot.
Sorry?
Yes. Yeah, you talk a lot about love.
I talk a lot about love, and that's what all my practices and my coaching is based around, because I learned it from my experiences, Ashish, and I know that unless you learn to love, you can't be happy. And by love, I don't mean in association with somebody on the outside necessarily. I mean the love that should start off with, the first point, the first port of call should be love towards you. So as a human being, you're definitely blessed with some unique skills. Each one of us is unique in our own way. We know the story of the DNA being totally unique to each other, and that's why we're all humans. We have basic features the same, but all our DNAs are very different. Now, how amazing is that? So once you know that from a scientific aspect, what is your reason to deny your greatness? Right? And I believe that the love should start from within, and anybody who's looking to achieve anything at all, be it love on the outside, happiness in their life, peace, you know, success in business, anything at all, that starts from accepting who you are. And that's what I call love, just acceptance, accepting who you are. Because if you keep denying your own truth, how are you going to embrace the good stuff on the outside? Right? So good and the bad, we're human beings, we're not all perfect, nobody's perfect. So accept, for example, you know, my memory isn't great. I forget quite things, so I make a lot of lists, you see. And I always talk about that. I'm teased by my children about that, and that's fine.
Yeah, Mr. Chevel is saying...
Mr. Chevel is saying... Your voice has gone really down, Ashish, even on my full volume. I can hardly hear you. Could you do something about that?
Isn't it correct? Mr. Chevel is saying Ritu is queen of love.
Oh, bless. Thank you. I'm a student, shall we say. A student of love. And I think that is such an important lesson I've learned in my life, Ashish, that I would like to spread it out to everyone. And that's what I try and do to everyone. And now all my workshops are based around love. Of course, we talk about success in business, and we talk about, you know, becoming more confident. Even when we do workshops for speaking, I try and tell my attendees that, you know what, you need to look inside, you need to connect within. You can't make genuine, authentic connections on the outside unless you have that connection inside. And it took me years and years to understand that. Unfortunately, I did not have a mentor or a coach at the time. I was struggling in life, going through the worst days. But they turned out to be my best teachers. And they turned my attention towards inside, because I was desperate for things on the outside, but I was ignoring me totally. So I learned the hard way. So I want everybody else to learn the easy way, to know that, you know, everything is possible. First, you become possible for yourself. You accept yourself. There's a reason you are the way you are, right? You might be called stubborn. You might be a black sheep. You know, you might be total misfit in the society. You might be thinking of a business idea that nobody agrees with. But if you believe in that, and if you know there's a reason you needed to come up with that idea, you will achieve it. And I am totally 100% in belief that once we know who we are, and we are genuinely accepted by ourselves, that is where great things start to happen, and life actually starts to unfold in front of us. And that's what I share with others now.
Okay. That's a great time. I think viewers had a lot of inputs from you about the mindset, about the love. Let us know, both of us, in the comments, what more you would like to know, what more you want, which all other inputs you would like to have about fear, mindset, motivation, anything like that. Because as I am on a mission to help you all to double your results in every aspect of life, Ritu is there to help you about mindset, motivation, and even alternative therapies also. So let us know in comments, And just give us some likes, just give us, just put on some shares so that we also feel motivated. We also feel motivated and feel to come next time with some enhanced spirits and some enhanced and some great content. It was great, Ritu, to be with you today. Let's connect together sometime.
Definitely. And so if I can just round up by telling people that they can connect with me on Facebook if they'd like to. I'm also on YouTube. I've got a YouTube channel, and all I talk about again is love on there. Right now I'm doing 40 Steps to Love, and I post a video every Monday, Sunday or Monday, depending on where I am with my children and my house, etc. And I'm on LinkedIn, I'm on Instagram, so if you'd like, you can connect to me on there. My website is www.ritusharma.co.uk, and I am bringing a confidence in speaking online course very shortly. But Ashish, I would like you to tell everybody who's watching this about you as well. You've been very quiet and I've been blabbering on, so I'd like you to tell people the great work you're doing in terms of your business as well, not just because you're a coach, we all know that, so maybe you should share about your business a bit as well.
Majority of time is major of the time is now involved with training students towards competitive examinations preparation. And I also train corporates and professionals towards peak performance. So when it comes to business, as I'm involved majorly with students and even the corporate professionals, so like you said, there is a kind of bonding and attachment. And without bonding and without attachment, without mission, there is nothing.
Mm-hmm.
It was just because of that mission, and it was because of that such great inner desire only, that both of us got in touch with each other few months ago. Actually, it's not much, as you said. So that's my core, talking to people, teaching people about bringing the peak performance. And I also tell people to bring the best out of them, and the best out of them could come only from their own personal results and their personal experiences. I can tell, you can tell, I can coach, you can coach. But if I ask somebody, what did I say 10 minutes ago? Most of the times, people might not be able to just clearly say it. Yeah, they'll not be able to recall. The only reason is because that's not their experience.
Yes.
So we have to experience whatever I say. Like whatever you said, that's your personal experience. Whatever I said and whatever I'm saying, it's through my personal experience. Some of the coachings, mentors, what do mentors do? There is always a great need of mentor, because my current mentor is also enhancing me as an individual. They are also bringing the best out of me. So as a mentor, when you have a mentor, when you have a person in your life who is a mentor, he brings the best out of you. So let's take that way, that you are a bird and the mentor just somehow opens up you into flower and you become a lotus flower. So that is the role of a mentor.
I have a business mentor, because I'm not very business minded, so I need guidelines sometimes and push. Although I'm very motivated, and you can sit here and chat to me for thousands of topics and I can carry on talking to you for the rest of the day, maybe that would not bother me. But obviously with business, it's a bit different, the tools and, you know, the marketing strategies, etc., that we need to use. And I need a business mentor to give me pointers towards that. We, as I said earlier, we each one of us has got great skill sets, but that's our skill set. Obviously, that's not the whole package. We need to collaborate with each other, as Ashish and I have decided to come on together to spread the message of beating the fears, you know, enhancing your mindset, getting the peak performances, all aspects of your life, etc., etc. I mean, that's the best way of approaching it. You go as you've just said it, you do that, Ashish, and I do that as well. I've got another mentor who's a mindset architect, and he coaches me on, you know, whenever I get stuck, because as I say, we're human beings, we can only go this far, and then we need a bit more push, and then we can only go this far again, we need a bigger push then. And that's how we work. And there's no shame or no harm in accepting that. And even the best of the best coaches have coaches, they have mentors, they have regular sessions. And I say, like, we feed our body every single day. It's also important to feed your spirit, to feed your mind, to grow more. Because you can't just take one feed, one meal, and then expect it to work for the rest of your life. You've got to keep growing. You've got to keep pouring in to be able to pour out. And I'm really pleased that you've said that, because I totally agree with that, totally resonate with that.
Okay. Thank you very much. I think that's all for the day. We should end the session now.
Lovely.
And
sure.
And let's leave this session to our viewers, and they should comment on now further.
Of course.
I think you also
very
would say.
Very welcome to say what you feel like saying. If there's a particular question, please ask away. I'll be more than happy to answer any questions. And just for the record, my book is called Rich Man's Poor Daughter. It is available on Amazon, but you can request a signed copy if you'd like. I'll be happy to post it out to you too.
Okay.
Okay,
thank you very much.
Sheesh, we will get in touch again, and hopefully we'll come back on again some other time talking about some of the great stuff. But thank you very much, Ashish, for taking the initiative today. I really do appreciate that. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, everyone. That's all for the day. Thank you.
Take care. Bye.